Legend of Total War here. This is part 12 of the Medieval 2 Peasant Campaign as Egypt. Obviously, it's been more than a year since this campaign. And yeah, just picking up from where we left off. So, we just took Yerevan a year ago. And now we're going to take Kaffa with my peasant fucking shit. So, obviously, as I said in the Iko Iki campaign, this is now live commentary. Not scripted commentary, so I can get this done a lot faster. So, like I said, should be looking at a scripted... what was a scripted episode once a week. So next episode would be the Empire Blitz. There's nothing to comment here. I just smashed these Turkish archers, no big deal. It's actually interesting watching me play this. This is when my computer didn't have certain upgrades, so it actually runs a lot better now. And even my compression settings when recording's a lot better. Anyway, we fucked up the Turks there. With peasants. God, this campaign was fucked. Is it difficult?
Allah, the most merciful, has delivered us.
Couldn't make up my mind whether to sack or occupy it. What'd I end up going with? Occupy? What the fuck? That's not like me. Yeah, definitely want to convert to a castle so that we can recruit peasants from there. There's absolutely no point in me having any towns at all. Even though they provide money, it was really about just recruiting as many peasants as possible. What am I doing here? Oh, I remember. Yeah, exploit time. I don't know why I decided this unit in particular, but I decided this is the agent squash. So yeah, if you look in the description, I'm pretty sure I made it clear at the very beginning I was going to use exploits. I was going to do anything that I could to win. And now what are we doing here? Taking on Thessalonica. I'm pretty sure at this stage, Corinth is under siege by the Byzantines.
We shall end this day in triumph.
Yes.
Orders, my and what are we doing here?
Admiring the enemy.
I don't know. We're gonna attack that. Heroic victory. Fuck, I didn't even need to quick save or quick load. I was lucky. I don't think I knew about the quick save or quick load stuff back then. This was a long time ago. This is more than 2 years ago. I was playing this.
How may I serve, Sultan?
What are we doing here? I'm sure I had some sort of scheme concocted to go and take Tbilisi.
We will smite this.
Then what else am I doing?
Yes,
gotta kill these motherfuckers, huh? Well, this obviously is not going to be a very important battle, but shit, any small victory we can get against the enemy is needed. So, really the only technique you can ever really use against the enemy. I don't know why I didn't change the weather conditions. This was shit. The only thing you can do is envelop them. But since they've got ballista, you kind of want to get in there really quickly as well. Because you don't want your peasants to die. It's actually funny watching me play this and seeing how much I've improved since then. Like, I thought it was good back then. Just by moving stuff around now, I think it's a lot better. Of course, I much prefer playing with cavalry. So let's surround these motherfuckers and kill them. You gotta surround them anyway, because otherwise if they, if they run away, then how the fuck are you supposed to catch them? Peasants can't run for shit. They're too busy being crap. That's it. Closing in on the motherfuckers and they probably break. Yep, there we go. And that's Saracen militia there, so That's some good quality units, but pretty much surrounding units and with this many, because that's the thing, if you swarm them with heaps of numbers, it makes such a big difference, even if technically our soldiers are complete garbage.
Enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost.
Nobody wants to be surrounded by a sea of fucking peasants. That's what I use the majority of the time to win.
Guard him. The present, let us show him we are civilized men. Victory is ours. Victory, both righteous and well deserved. It cannot be said otherwise.
Good, smashed him up good. Only, shit, that's a 20 to 1 kill ratio. Not too bad for peasants. Very small scale battle. No, execute them!
Do not
kill them!
Abandon your honor.
Good. And then what are we doing? Yeah, you want to keep that spy with lots of experience and try and retrain him. His experience will make a big difference.
How may I serve, Sultan?
Just checking to see if
How may I serve, Sultan?
Yep, there's no public order penalties. Plus, we can also lower the tax rate.
Orders. How may I serve,
and now we, what are you doing? Come on, fucking besiege, build the siege equipment. I don't know what I did there. I didn't build it. What the fuck am I doing here? I mean, if I had cavalry, this would make sense. I kind of remember this. I remember this. This is fucked. Because I knew that I could win the siege of Jerusalem if they assaulted that turn. Because, as you can see there, they've got a ram and a lot of ladders. However, I'm pretty sure they were not going to sally out. I'm not going to assault. They were going to wait until they built more siege equipment. So what I did was I came out here to lose just a few of my men, which is actually, in hindsight, a bit of a waste of time. I should have just disbanded them. Just to lose a few of my men so that they felt confident to attack. And don't worry, we will see the assault of Jerusalem in this episode. So yeah, this is... In hindsight, this was a bit silly. But given my options at the time, I was like, what the fuck am I supposed to do? We needed to make sure they didn't have more siege equipment, so we had to make sure they assaulted that turn, because we could have neutralized the battering ram very easily, and then just fought them with them getting up on the ladders very easily. So I think I'm just going to send a few units to go and fight. Probably could have skipped this. This is boring as fuck. So I think I just send a few... Come on, hurry up. Send a few units over there to die. Because they're just going to sit there. There was no way of enveloping this army. I would have had to have killed that general. And there's no way these... It would require all of these guys to fight the general. Just to kill that guy. But then the others as well. That probably wouldn't have had anything left. So yeah, the point of this battle wasn't to win, it was just to do a bit of damage to them. Have a bit of damage done to me. Obviously more damage done to me than to them, so to make sure they assault. I really think I could have handled this situation a lot better if I had done this now. Sometimes I think back to the peasant campaign and think, I really could have done that a lot better. I mean, I did do the Blitz campaign twice, but fucked if you think I'm going to do this one twice. Hell no. This campaign must have consumed about 2 months of my time. It's so long. And all you get to use is peasants, no cavalry, it's fucked. Yeah, sometimes I get people asking me, why don't you play a campaign where you don't have cavalry? Well, here the fuck it is! There's no cavalry at all. Ever.
Curse the sun that shines on our disgrace! We must turn the wind of battle, or we will taste ashes instead of victory!
You can see I lost a few units there. And I'm pretty sure in a minute we're going to be sending our guys back inside. And then call it a draw. Even though they got the better of us, but that's what we were hoping to get. Them to have the better of us. Yep, there I go. Sending everyone back inside. Go, go, go. So obviously, if you just finished watching the previous episode, part 11, you'll notice not the squeaky voice anymore. Although I wouldn't say it was a squeaky voice, it's just much deeper now. Because I've done voice training. I've become older. Come on, hurry up and get them inside so we can move on to an actually interesting battle. So, how do we go? We lost 59 men. No, other way around. We lost 305. We killed 59 of them. Obviously not a good result, but that's what we're looking for. And they executed those that they captured, which is, I guess, we'll be fine. I think we're sending these guys over there to take out those rebels. Problem is, obviously, we could get a man of the hour, but we don't want it. We can't use generals. I remember I was hemorrhaging money. So obviously, you can see the jump in. Alright, post end turn. I didn't show every little thing in this because this is such a huge campaign. And most of it was just there going, what should I fucking buy? Okay, so here comes the assault of Jerusalem. Believe it or not, the forces that we have here should be sufficient to defeat that. Because they haven't brought enough variety of units. They've just brought melee spear infantry. They haven't brought any knights, they haven't brought any archers, they haven't brought any artillery. So this is pretty easy to beat. All we gotta do is sally out a little bit. And the AI does this too, so don't go fucking calling this an exploit. The AI fucking does this. They sally out to go and attack your battering ram. Then they drop the battering ram, and they never pick it back up. Because as long as the ladders make it to the wall, they consider it, okay, well, the battering ram didn't work, we might as well use the ladders. And as long as the towers continue to shoot, we should have a sufficient force to keep them at bay whilst the towers shoot. So, yep, doesn't matter that they broke early. All that matters is that they attack the battering ram. Good, and then these motherfuckers will come up on the wall.
The ladders have reached the walls. Defend your homes and
it's a very long-winded fight. There's obviously not much tactics involved in it at this point. Just making sure that they don't open the gate, because the thing is, if that general gets inside, their generals are the biggest threat. If you don't fight their general, if you manage to beat them without fighting their generals, then that's always ideal. At least at this stage in the campaign. Later on, when we've got 9 experienced units, we can fight generals. As in amongst other armies. Most notably the Mongols. Anyway, they'll come there, they'll try and capture those units, but any units that they capture, well obviously I'll just get them back if I win. So they fight there, but as they're fighting, they're getting shot as well. As you can see. The occasional arrow going by. But one-on-one, their troops are better than mine. Good, they're getting... I don't know what they're doing. We're not losing that many guys up on the wall there. Like I said, we just need to make sure they don't get near the center gatehouse. If you can do that, the towers will keep shooting them. You can see in the distance, all of their units are now climbing up the ladders. Okay, so you can see at this point, we've gone by a bit of time. All of those units that have been shot there, you can see the balance of power slightly moved in our favor. We've lost a lot of guys, but that's everything that they've got left being shot there. So you might be able to see the occasional shot coming through there and hitting them in the face. And that's what it was all about. Getting a bit of a mass rout. And the thing is with the Milanese, if they lose this battle, they've got nowhere to go to because they're on crusade. They don't have any ships nearby or anything like that. There's no friendly territory, so if they lose, they die. That's kind of the good thing about a crusade, if they come at you. If you defeat them, they've got nowhere to go to, they're gone. Apart from the fact that a crusade can be terrifying if they send, like, multiple nations and multiple stacks at you. So what's going on here? Well, we burnt down their ram anyway. Fuck them. Piece of shit. sending a few units up on the wall, or sending some more guys up on the wall, or... Wait, they took a ladder down. Yeah, like, that's gonna fucking help them.
Pardons, wisest one, but that siege machine is not going to man itself.
And then there was just one unit there, like, just two men standing behind there, but they're protected by the ruins of, or the wreckage of the ram. So what you gotta do is send someone just to go fight them. Because as soon as they break, we win the battle, and we don't even have to fight their general. Come on, open the fucking door and get out. There we go. There we go, victory! Even though the bounce pal is still not in our favor, managed to get a better 2-to-1 kill ratio, so I'm pretty happy with that. Plus also, we'll get all of our captured units back, those extra 130, so it's actually more like 3-to-1 kill ratio. Try and get a ransom, because you know they're dead anyway. Anyway, guys, I think that is the end of this episode. So, we'll try and get some more out to you soon. So, like and subscribe. Part 13 will be next. And don't forget to visit me on Facebook. And I'll see you next time, fuckers.